Hello Windows Universe, in this video we will talk about if Disk Defragmenter will not run or start in Windows 10. For a more in-depth look at the topic, we will link an article in the description down below. The System File Checker will examine all the system files and see if any have been corrupted. To do this, open a command prompt as an administrator. Type in sfc space slash scan now, all one word, and hit enter. Once that's finished, type in exit, restart your system, and check to see if the defragmenter is working then. Checking the status of a service can also help. In the task search bar, type in services.msc to open the services manager. We're going to make sure that the Disk Defragmenter is not disabled but set to manual. This service, Defrag SVC, is new from Windows 7 and beyond and is used to defragment disks on a schedule. If you cannot find Defrag service, it might be listed as optimized drives. This is common in systems that run on an SSD and not a hard drive. When you find it, double click on it, make sure that it is set to manual and that it is running. While we're here, we need to also check remote procedure call. Make sure that it is running. RPC endpoint mapper. And DCOM server process launcher. Another fix is to run ChkDsk. Open the command prompt as an administrator. Type in chkdsk space slash r. The R switch identifies bad sectors and will attempt recovery of information. Hit enter. You might get this particular message that says that the volume is in use by another process. That's especially if you're checking the C drive. It will just ask if you'd like to schedule this volume to be checked the next time the system restarts. If that's the case, select yes, and then restart your system. Make sure that the page file is not disabled. To do this, we'll need to open the control panel. Go to All Control Panel Items. System, Advanced System Settings. On the Advanced tab, we're looking for Performance and we want to click on Settings. Go into Advanced. Under Virtual Memory, click on Change. Ensure that automatically manage paging file size for all drives is checked. And make sure that no paging file is not selected. Click OK. Click OK. Click OK. Restart your system to let the changes take effect. If nothing else works, trying a system restore might help. To do this, type restore in. Click on system restore. And follow any of the on-screen prompts to restore your system to an earlier time period. For more helpful tips to maximize your window experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Give this video a thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe to our channel. We are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.